Instead of me, he was here at the Sagatino territory. I was there. But I returned home and started to study in some college. I finished this college in 1950 and become a, I don't know how to call it here, bachelor of technical science. Like I work on the special factories and continue to study higher. Then in 1951 I served in Soviet Army from 1951 until October 1954. After Army I get married my wife was in 54, married, and I live in Minsk, and then when her mother passed away, I returned back to her in Gomery and lived there. Besides, I work, I continue to study in university. This is Poly University, Polytech.
Polytechnical?
Polytechnический институт. It's like higher education. Mm-hmm. Like here you have master degree. I finished, have master degree. And start to work in special factory, like chief mechanic, engineer. And work there until I live there many years. All my children, they got good education, and we get there until 1993. Until this, 1993, my younger brother, he came to United States earlier than me. He's still alive. He is 80 years old, would be tomorrow, and live in Sacramento. And my older brother is also alive. He is 87 and live now in San Jose. We left Gomery in 1993 and living here in San Mateo. We came like the family, how to say, family together. The younger brother and here we all now in America. Our children, grandchildren, they finish colleges, and one of them master's degree has in LA, the University of LA, there, and all working here. And that is short biography, what the time was.
When you were younger, what kind of work did your father and mother do?
My mother was, she worked on the fabric. When you...
Textiles or sewing?
Sewing, yeah. She was working there. And my father was a counter.
How was Jewish life like in your community? Were people very observant or very religious?
Were they deep?
Yeah, when you were younger, when you were a child.
No. In Soviet Union, the religion is forbidden. And we, our older people were not here because for father's side, his relatives, they live in Israel. And we live here. No connection in religion we didn't have. So that's because we didn't know any way to get them. It wasn't no synagogue there.
Yeah.
Nothing.
Did you know other Jewish families in
Yeah, of course we know Jewish family only. But the language was only Russian. We have not, like here, you have in synagogues everywhere you continue to support this the
community.
Rules or policy for living, like and staying by Talmud or some religious Torah or Kabbalah, there was nothing. Only here we find out something to find out, but we know about Jewish people, we know about it was hard to live there always, but until after war, it was anti-Semitism more than before the war too, because in beginning it looks like Jewish people have the same rights, but in the life, how happened? It wasn't this. It was lie. That's it. It was not correct. I know that about myself, my children, because they was forbidden for get some special education, special some work, what you deserve. And that's we know. That's because we have no freedom, and a lot of things surrounding us told us that for you it's okay, but for your children it's really not okay to live here. If you can, you have to leave. And that was the accident with my brother. He left, his family left, and we also leave from there. And that's in United States of America. That short explanation.
Was there much... I know you said there was much more anti-Semitic after the war, but was there any anti-Semitism before the war?
It was, but we were children, younger children, we not so feel it, we, young children. If you're a child playing with other children, you cannot exactly tell what you are, Jew or something. If also if you're not so like them looking differently, for example, if I do not know if you're Jew, can I say you're Jew? No, you're young, you cannot. That is because our outside looking like, you cannot say exactly. And your language, your accent, also not Jewish. You never speak Jewish and never live with them. You have not the same...
Yeah, sorry.
...compassion. But it was exist, anti-Semitism, always. Now we know for sure, because we have some explanation, movies from their side,
yeah.
Who openly opened the archive, and then the pronunciation is not so clear, but we knew, but we always was in warning position, be careful, do not tell anything, do not ask, do not move, follow, be shy. It was, anti-Semitism was, and it exists now everywhere, not only there, but it exists here also.
Unfortunately.
You have to fight.
When did you first learn?